Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will explain why organizations should embrace automated vulnerability scanning and various scanning mechanisms and list some of the most popular automated vulnerability scanners. So let's get started. One of the most crucial roles of an IT security administrator involves comprehensive vulnerability management, assessing, mitigating, and reporting security weaknesses and cyber threats within the organization's tech stack. To help with this, an automated vulnerability scanner forms the foundation of vulnerability management as it enables the identification and discovery of potential weaknesses. Vulnerability scanning involves applications that help teams create an inventory of all systems and devices connected to the organization's network. The scanner also takes note of the operating system, the software it runs, and other details relevant to security management for every inventory asset. Vulnerability scanners identify various assets within the network, including servers, laptops, firewalls, printers, containers, firewalls, etc., and constantly collect their operational details. In addition, these scanning tools have combinations of capabilities for auditing, logging, threat modeling, reporting, and remediation that allow organizations to assess their varying levels of security issues at any given time. Apart from being considered a common best practice in enterprise networks, government regulations and industry standards often require vulnerability scanners to maintain data protection and enhanced security. Though use cases may differ for different organizations, some commonly known benefits of embracing automated vulnerability scanning include the following. Proactive security. Hackers typically rely on application vulnerability to gain initial entry into the system. Automated vulnerability scanning lets teams detect and fix these vulnerabilities before they are used to compromise the organization's assets. Risk assessment. Regular vulnerability scans enable IT security teams to assess how effective their security controls are. However, when security experts constantly have to fix bugs and weaknesses, it's time to rethink the entire security strategy. Reduced costs and development time. Automated scans seamlessly perform tests that would have been time-consuming if humans had done them. Additionally, vulnerability scans enable the mitigation of attacks that would be costly to remediate. Compliance. Several compliance regulations require processing data that follows appropriate technical and security measures. Such compliance standards include the General Data Protection Regulation, Health Information Privacy and Accountability Act, and the Payment Card Industry Data Security Standard. The vulnerability management process. The process for detecting possible threats while minimizing the risk and possibility of attack involves vulnerability identification. Organizations use tools that rely on vulnerability databases and threat intelligence techniques to identify compromised components and then create an inventory of those to be fixed. Vulnerability scanning enables complete, real-time monitoring to identify threats as soon as they arise. Risk evaluation. Once vulnerabilities have been identified, they are weighed against a scoring system to evaluate their impact based on their effects, temporal traits, and inherent characteristics. This evaluation enables teams to identify the severe risks and prioritize their patches for efficient remediation. Remediation. Once vulnerabilities have been prioritized, security professionals conceptualize a plan to start fixing weaknesses. The plan also includes measures to boost monitoring and restrict access to high-risk subsystems to hold off attacks until patches have been applied. Reporting. Documenting and reporting the vulnerabilities identified and the applied remediation techniques is essential to improve awareness and future security posture. Reporting may also be required for compliance and to build an organization's reputation for accountability. Vulnerability scanning can be categorized into internal vulnerability scanning. Internal scans target an organization's internal network. While doing so, scanners identify weaknesses that attack vectors can use once they are inside the system or malicious employees. External vulnerability scanning. The external scan mechanism targets its systems exposed to the internet, such as external-facing applications, networks, services, ports, and websites. These scanners identify vulnerabilities that arise when systems need to be accessed by customers and other external users. Authenticated versus unauthenticated scanning. Authenticated scans require internal access to the organization's IT ecosystem, so they require logins for a trusted user's eye view of the security environment. Unauthenticated, non-credentialed scans do not get trusted access into the system, but offer valuable security insights from an attacker's or external user's point of view. Choosing an automated vulnerability scanner tool. The security testing market includes a wide range of vulnerability scanners. Evaluating an appropriate choice is challenging. This section guides the considerations for automated vulnerability scanning and the types of vulnerability scanners. Factors to consider when selecting an automated vulnerability scanner. Here are some criteria to base the assessment of appropriate vulnerability scanners. A variety of vulnerability tests covered. While it is essential for a vulnerability scanner to identify common and basic vulnerabilities, the ideal tool should include a broad range of security tests. This reduces the cost and complexity of setting up the security monitoring system while allowing teams to avoid unnecessary integrations that may contain security blind spots. Web technology coverage. Most vulnerability scanners begin by crawling the entire web application to completely view the infrastructure's security posture. However, scanners can only perform this if they integrate tools to identify every web application form, page, and element. The suitable vulnerability scanner should also identify these elements across multiple development stacks, frameworks, and deployment environments for effective vulnerability management. Ease of use. Vulnerability scanning is a complex and comprehensive process that requires deep knowledge of the organization's networks, devices, and services. Additionally, not everyone in an organization understands vulnerability scanning beyond the basics. Therefore, the vulnerability scanning tool should abstract all the manual labor to identify and detect threats so that teams can focus on value-adding activities. Speed and test quality. Vulnerability scanning aims to find security threats for immediate remediation. The vulnerability scanning tool should, as a result, identify the operational state of all the application's resources within a short time and update the vulnerability inventory frequently. However, the tool should ensure high-quality vulnerability testing and reporting by minimizing false positives. Compliance. Some industries, such as healthcare, finance, and defense, often require deeper vulnerability assessment and reporting as part of regulatory configuration compliance. Therefore, the selected tool should implement security according to standards outlined by the governing body, such as HIPAA, GDPR, and ISO. Remediation recommendations. Some tools include automated remediation for common vulnerabilities and recommendations for more complex ones for organizations that want to automate their vulnerability scans fully. These are particularly useful for cross-functional teams where security is a shared responsibility of the entire organization. Based on their operation modes and environments, automated vulnerability scanners can be categorized into network-based scanners. Network vulnerability scanners are used to discover compromised network devices connected to the organization through external-facing networks. These tools aim to enable security teams to identify network perimeter points that may present an attack surface. Host-based scanners. These crawl network hosts such as workstations, servers, and laptops for operational details such as patch history and configuration settings. These scanners enable security teams to identify the damage if an attacker accessed the system using an authenticated device. Wireless scanners. These wireless scan networks validate the company's security posture and detect rogue attack access points. Application vulnerability scanner. Such scanners include dynamic application security tests, interactive application security tests, static application security tests, and runtime application self-protection tools. Database scanners. Most web applications rely on databases to store critical information. Database scanners identify vulnerabilities in database management systems, such as SQL injection attack vulnerabilities. Automated vulnerability scanning tools include independent, high-level tests that scan applications for potential vulnerabilities and create detailed reports, often including remediation recommendations. These tools eliminate the manual effort required to check whether an organization's systems, networks, and devices have vulnerabilities that may compromise security. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.